In California, city volunteers bring care to a single mother living in a trailer home. At the year-end blessing ceremony at Xindian Jing Si Hall, volunteers arrive to collect blessings and receive certification. Welcome to DaAi Headlines, I'm Hu Chiao. Glad to have you here. In California, USA, after the Camp wildfire in 2018, Tzu Chi has continued to care for the affected people. A single mother, homeless after the wildfire, lives in a broken trailer home. Upon learning her situation, Tzu Chi helped her find a better trailer and improve her life.
When I met her, she was there at the church with her not even two-year-old granddaughter, and she was like homeless. And we start talking, and it was like, you know, were you in the campfire and stuff? And she was saying, well, yeah.
A woman living in a very condemned trailer on the street, unsafe neighborhood, and trying to figure out every day her water, food, and she didn't have electricity.
She's struggling in this world of being like a 40-year-old single mom with a granddaughter and still having lived a really hard life, but wanting to do well.
I had nothing, nowhere to go, barely got a vehicle, lived in and out of my vehicle. It was just me and my granddaughter, you know. Until I got this.
The improvement of the trailer she is in now, I mean, literally, safety. The other one did not have a door that could fasten or even lock. And the one that she has now is, I'm gonna say, maybe double or close to almost three times that size. It has three beds for children in the back. She has her own private space up front. Kitchen, all electricity works. She has air conditioning.
Now, Lynette's been one of the key people. She's a great hard worker, and fortunately with Alliance for Workforce, she's been able to stay here and work, helping us with the furniture distribution, helping with the food distribution. Some of the things you guys have done have just been so wonderful. It really warms our heart. We really, really appreciate everything you guys are doing.
Congrats.
Thank you.
I am so happy for you, more than you realize. I'm just honored to be in service and also to be a part of such an organization that has allowed me to expand in my heart space to be able to hold such a frequency of love, to be an example.
And it's hard for me to actually just to close a case like that. You know, okay, here, we helped you. We're not gonna ever help you again. You know, because I still would want her to know that she can call me if she has issues, and you know, I don't mind telling her my opinions and what works for me. It's just, there's a lot of women up there that are struggling.
Tzu Chi provided a better home and transportation for me, getting me something better to live in and something a little better to maybe move forward in life. Just thank you.
In Indonesia's Simpak village, since 2012, Tzu Chi has been providing relief plans to local villagers. On the way to the village, volunteers discover the roads have serious deterioration. Thus, they want to renovate the roads on behalf of villagers. After the renovation, villagers arrive to celebrate. Being in the dessert industry, Polong lives in Simpak village, and every day before dawn, he must drive to Jakarta to deliver goods. While driving, the road conditions outside of the village frightened him.
Before renovation, the roads outside of the village have poor condition. It's filled with crushed stones, so we must drive slowly. In the nighttime, there is no light. So if we drive a little faster, the tires of the vehicle could be pierced by stones.
Due to the Tzu Chi relief program since 2012, a connection was made between Tzu Chi Indonesia chapter and Simpak village. After nearly 10 years of interaction, the bond became stronger, as city volunteers decide to help renovate roads on behalf of villagers.
At Simpak village, there are many people in poverty, and because of inconvenience of transportation, we hope to improve the roads, allowing people to travel with convenience and safety.
After 20 days of renovation, the 700-meter-long road is ready to service villagers. In order to thank Tzu, villagers named the road with Tzu's name in it.
In the past, if we wanted to exit the village, we must go around a mountain, and it's tough to drive there during the rainy season. Later on, villagers fundraise for a road, and now Tzu renovates the roads for us, so our problem with traffic is resolved.
The villagers here are very nice. When we were doing road renovations, they helped us and even prepared coffee and desserts for workers. Today, the renovation comes to an end. The villagers seem to be happy.
Besides assisting villagers in having a safe road to walk on, Tzu also brought in gifts of love, as these rice packages will allow villagers to have a wonderful Christmas. Tzu Hospital Indonesia started planning in 2013 and began construction in 2015. The construction that has lasted for many years has finally been completed this year. Recently, team of members from Bandung came to visit the hospital, hoping to bring back medical knowledge and to provide better quality services to patients in the future.
Tzu Hospital Indonesia, which only opened in October, was recently visited by a group of team members from Bandung.
This hospital occupies a very large area. It's 10 hectares, 23 stories high, and there are more than 500 beds. The superintendent took us to visit the hospital equipment and found that they are all the most advanced medical equipment. It's really incredible. And I also admire your hospital's humanistic medical care that is people-oriented and treats the patients as our own relatives.
Because of the pandemic, Tzu Hospital Indonesia opened the Academic Prevention Center in mid-June, which has been in operation for nearly half a year, has served many patients in the community.
Our hospital is equipped with complete medical equipment, but we also expect all medical staff to treat patients as their relatives. In addition to providing professional medical services to patients, medical staff should also care for patients and their families with empathy. Only in this way can the patient's condition recover quickly.
I hope that in the future, this hospital can retain its original ambitions and make it a medical service full of warmth for the community.
Medical staff in two cities exchange experiences and learn from each other, hoping to get more inspiration to serve patients and solve their problems.
Nantou Shui Li Town's famous Jianjiao ceremony, a Taoist tradition, is held every 12 years to thank the deities at the start of winter. This year, the ceremony of a celebration of Yuanjiao, the completion. Local residents all vowed to go meatless for 3 days, leading many of the nearby stores to also adopt the vegetarian menu for the duration. Let's take a look.
Shui Li City's famous fried snacks has a fried yams, taro cake, and cilantro tempura. This menu change has not affected their business whatsoever.
Shui Li's Jianjiao ceremony encourages us to eat vegetarian for 3 days. We switch our menu for the time being.
The Vietnamese vendor nearby is also going vegetarian too.
This morning, many of the tourists came and wondered why our menu was vegetarian today, but they still ordered from it.
Nantou's Shui Li Township is hosting its once every 12 years Jianjiao Festival, a Taoist tradition. This year is to celebrate Yuanjiao, or the completion. The entire township is adopting a vegetarian diet for 3 days.
This is the famous Chechen Park in Shui Li. During these 3 days, the visitors are also adhering to vegetarian eating.
I normally eat vegetarian food anyway, so I'm pretty happy I have more choices now.
We have prepared vegetarian lunchboxes, including stir-fried noodles and noodle soup. It's been well received.
Since there are about 17,000 residents in Shui Li and on the average about 400 tourists a day, so if they all went vegan for 3 days at 2 kilograms per day, this means more than 104 tons of carbon emission is actively reduced.
We hope to bring about a peaceful atmosphere to our residents here, and it can help to purify their spirit.
With sincerity in keeping to a vegetarian diet, the entire town is surely to have plenty of blessings for years to come.
At Xindian Jing Si Hall's year-end blessing ceremony, people arrived to receive certifications. A couple at the scene fulfilled their dreams of becoming Tzu Chi honorary board members. Another volunteer, Wang Lianying, arrived to receive certification as she inherited her mother's spirit of becoming a Tzu Chi volunteer. In order to accompany her 83-year-old mother in doing Tzu Chi work, Wang Lianying reports into the recycling station on a daily basis. She jokes about being the crutch of her mother, and as time goes on, she joins Tzu Chi.
After we cut it, it becomes trash. It's really incredible, and only Tzu Chi will sort it with detail.
Not only practicing recycling, volunteer Wang Lianying also participates in study groups. After 2 years of volunteer training, she is finally receiving certification this year.
What I'm wearing now is my mother's jacket, 旗袍, and her Dharma wisdom. I have fully inherited her ideals.
As newly certified members from Zhongzhen and Neihu gather at the Xindian Jing Si Hall, after the ceremony, volunteers recognize their mission and the start of their responsibilities.
After I received my name tag, I felt very blessed to follow Master Zheng Yan's footsteps.
In the past, Chen Liming relied on recycling to make a living for her household, and after losing her husband, she felt helpless. But after viewing the DaAi drama, she felt happy as she is now doing charity. At the year-end blessing ceremony, people at the scene felt blessed to be guided by Tzu Chi, overcoming their obstacles in life. Couple Huang Weixuan and Liao Meiling did charity along the way, and at the ceremony this year, they both become Tzu Chi honorary board members.
After we looked at each other, I thought I originally wanted to fulfill her dream of becoming an honorary member, and she thought of fulfilling my dream.
After walking on Tzu Chi's path, my heart opened up and my field have expanded. I am thankful to Tzu Chi.
With similar directions and goals, people at the year-end blessing vow the same aspirations and welcome the upcoming year, hoping to do more good deeds that benefit sentient beings. Wuchang Elementary School, Zhongshan District, Taipei City, held an environmental education exhibition. The four-day event, including elementary schools and attached kindergartens, was attended by 1,115 teachers and students. Let's join them there.
If these children pass the level successfully, they will get a PET bottle cap as points. 84-year-old Xu Xianhai was very active in explaining paper recycling knowledge to elementary school students.
The disposable tableware for buffet can be recycled, but it needs the residue to be rinsed away first. I teach the children starting from the most basic knowledge about environmental protection, which will benefit them when they grow up.
Liu Decai, with silver hair and white eyebrows, praised the children for their learning enthusiastically.
You are great. Good job. The kids are very innocent. We teach them since they are young. They'll actually remember well. Being a volunteer, especially to get along with children, is really a very happy thing.
I found that the children are very interested in the event. I think it is because of the content of this theme, which is all related to daily life, so we can guide the children to practice environmental friendliness in their lives.
Whose parents or elder brothers and sisters will bring along this container when they go to buy a bento? Raise your hand. Oh, your grandpa is so great. To encourage your grandpa, we'd like to give him a pen.
Volunteers praised and rewarded a family who is dedicated to environmental protection, filling the students with a sense of honor, hoping that they will be more active in protecting the environment.
Tzu Chi University cooperated with Hualien Agricultural Senior High School to help Yichang Primary School set up a smart agriculture demonstration base. Using smart monitoring of hydroponic planting, to keep a hold of indoor temperature, humidity, and other related data. Here's more.
Children find it special for hydroponic planting. in which soil is replaced by water, while sunlight is replaced by light.
This one is now planted in water. I usually see it grows in the soil and absorbs nutrients from the soil. I don't know what nutrients are there in the water.
Farmers may not have to go out to work in the rice field every day. This requires less effort.
In an industry university cooperation project, Tzu University worked together with the Huanan Agricultural Senior High School to set up a smart agricultural demonstration base for Yichang Primary School.
In this space, the real-time room temperature, water temperature, carbon dioxide, humidity, and even the pH value in the water, the total amount of fertilizer estimated by the computer. The dissolved oxygen value in the water, with such a technology, we can get all these real-time data for doing line graphs.
Relevant data is collected and uploaded to the cloud to share with farmers.
We hope to upload this data to the public platform. A single piece of data is actually less meaningful, but putting everyone's data together, the ultimate data will be very reliable.
Breaking through environmental factors of nature, everyone can grow perfect vegetables indoors. Using smart technology brings more possibilities to agriculture, as more farmers can also take the first step in agricultural development.
In Jingmen, teachers from Tzu Chi Teachers Association and Tzu Chi volunteers held a camp for disadvantaged children who are cared by Tzu Chi for a long time. The courses provide children with the concepts of environmental protection, etiquette, and vegetarianism.
The children's laughter was heard at the Tzu Chi Jinmen retreat. Volunteers dress up as characters in the movie and perform short plays about loving the earth, immediately attracting children's attention.
We want to appeal to children that vegetarianism is not only good for their own health, but also good for the planet. More importantly, being a vegetarian is also a respect for life and a love for animals.
When I saw animals being killed mercilessly by people, I feel terrible, so I decided to go vegetarian for the rest of my life. In this class, I learned love.
Through the two-day campaign events, the children learn etiquette, environmental protection, and Tzu Chi humanities. Practicing calligraphy writing can also calm their minds, and children have gained a lot from it. Volunteers came to Jinmen, an offshore island of Taiwan, to show the seeds of the goodness and love, and that love take root locally.
According to the Ministry of the Interior, in Taiwan, approximately 56,000 people own the certificate of vision impairment. The one group of people, the patients with MDVI, are included in the criteria. Living in Taichung, Yuan Jingjuan, in order to take care of her son with MDVI, formed the Taiwan Association for MDVI, helping over 50 families in Taiwan. Let's take a look.
In Taiwan, compulsory education is up to 18 years old. After reaching that age, many children with MDVI will be rejected from daycare centers, workshop, and nursing homes. I've asked many institutes which take in people with severe symptoms. They don't want to take in my child.
Rejected by multiple long-term care institutes, Zhen Han's parents finally found a care institute that also provides residency.
早安, 徐仁翰! 起床了! 早安,拿上衣,拿一件外套哦 OK
We will normally shift their attention, letting him stand on one foot and count from 1 to 100. They won't bite our hands or scream.
My child participates in a lot of events in HMSH, and it has improved my child's emotions, verbal, and communication skills.
Learning to incorporate into society, the Institute has slowed down the deterioration of Renhan's disabilities, though another patient with MDVI, Ren Yo, isn't as lucky as Ren Han. Sometimes with poor temper, Ren Yo is unable to communicate verbally, thus he communicates through colliding with another person. Though Ren Yo is already an adult, he remained the looks of an 8-year-old child.
It's hard to accept Ren Yo's illness because I love children. I originally wanted to have 3 children, but because of Ren Yo's situation, I told my husband we cannot have another child. He agreed and said it's fine, we together should take care of Ren Yo.
Taking care of children full-time, though parents try their best, it's still hard for their children to understand things at home. Therefore, it is crucial to pair their child with a professional.
吃饱饭啊，要做什么事情，要去拿什么？南瓜。那你刷牙的时候还需要什么东西？摸摸看。肚子被的问题。Using
3D printing to create teaching materials, these teachers allowed students to touch and feel objects, training their creativity and an imagination capacity.
Many children with MDVI, besides having visual impairment, they are 70 to 80% slower in learning progress compared to others, so they must use the sense of hearing or the tactile feedback to learn.
If the child is not taught well at home, teacher Luo will teach these children with patience.
Normally, people choose to love children who are cute, but my belief tells me to love children that need help.
Even though the love amassed from school and family is great, it still isn't enough to fill the empty holes in the life of a patient with MDVI.
As we get older and start to get ill, I don't know who will take care of these children. So we created a Taiwan Association for MDVI, creating a space where both parents and children to interact till they are old. We must age along with our children.
With the power of love, parents go on to accompany their children through their journey in life. The first senior gym in Hualien opened in Tzu University and is open to citizens above 50 years old for registration. On the first day of classes, 20 seniors joined in as they were accompanied by professional coaches. The devices at the gym come with a special design which allows seniors to work out more easily. Thank you for watching, see you next time.